and a very warm welcome to Bharata First. I'm Frank Rausen Pereira. This is FRP Explains First. Let me inform you about Bharata First Knowledge Center, a learning experience like none other. It will not only prepare you for your competitive exams journey, but get you better prepared for life itself. It's an all-new experience, like something you've never seen before. Go to kc.bharatafirst.com and register now and make use of the limited period early bird offer. Since you're here, please like the video, subscribe, hit the bell icon and then all notifications, and do share the content as well so that more people get to know about Bharata First. So let's talk about what's happening in the Supreme Court. Two judges in particular, Aniruddha Bose and Indira Banerjee, have recused themselves with regards to matters concerning West Bengal. One is the Narada case and the other one is the violence that was reported during the elections in West Bengal. Now, several people have spoken about why they have recused themselves, some of them even going to the extent of suggesting that because the judges' families live in West Bengal, so they are scared for their families and their own lives. So that shows what hooliganism the TMC is up to, and that's why they are recusing themselves. So this matter is very serious and needs to be looked at. Well, I don't know anything about that, and I'm not going to pass judgment on that. That is left up to you. But let me just narrate the entire story to you. So what happens and why do judges recuse themselves? One, if there is a conflict of interest and if the judges have some shares in some company or some kind of a membership from the family within that company or the party concerned, then the judge recuses himself or herself. Also, if the judge has been a part of a judgment that he had given in a high court and that matter then came up before the Supreme Court, then the issue can be raised and the judge can be recused because it becomes a conflict of interest, because the judge's views are already known with regards to the judgment passed in the high court. So these are some of the reasons why judges can recuse themselves or are recused. There is no formal rule or set or laid out procedure, and if a judge recuses him or herself, then the judge doesn't have to give a reason why it has been done. Some judges, of course, in the past have made given out reasons as well as to why they have recuse themselves, and it's not mandatory that a reason has to be given. They have given it in open court too. So this is a broad outline as far as what recusal means in the courts. Now, as far as these two cases are concerned, Narada as well as the violence in West Bengal, these are two very serious issues, and the matters are being independently taken up in the High Court as well and in the Supreme Court too. The High Court has been moving forward. The Kolkata High Court has been moving forward with regards to, holding those responsible accountable as well. But in the Supreme Court, the matter is still, hanging in limbo. The matter has been put forth before another bench now, which will listen to the matter on Friday. And let's see where it goes from there. But in the meantime, of course, we have to ensure that if something has gone wrong, that the courts step up and take action, because lives have been lost. There has been massive violence. There have been protests that have taken place in front of the governor's house as well in West Bengal. So all these matters need to be considered. As far as the Narada scam is concerned, don't forget, there have been thousands of people who have been looted. Several members of then TMC were directly involved with regards to the Narada scam. It was a sting operation that was carried out by a journalist and completely exposed several politicians. Many of them have switched parties thereafter. And, we've seen that the investigative agencies have been dragging their feet and going after only members of particular political parties, whereas the other political parties' members have been given a bit of a breather, so to speak. So these kind of aspects need to be looked at, looked into, and at the end of the day, justice needs to prevail. With that, it's a wrap on this edition of FRP Explains. If you like the content, you may like the video, subscribe, hit the bell icon, and then all notifications. For those of you who would like to come forward and make a contribution, you may do so using our UPI IDs. A small contribution that you make will be a giant leap for us to keep bringing you this content. In case you have trouble with UPI IDs, you may click on the payment link in the description below and follow the steps. Also, before I go, let me remind you once again about Bharata First Knowledge Center. It's a learning experience like never before. It will transform the way you gain knowledge. It will not only help you in your competitive exams journey, but will help you in facing life itself and make you a better Bharatiya. Go to kc.bharatafirst.com, get all the details and register today, because there's an early bird limited period offer. Make full use of it. You won't regret it. That's it from me. See you again next time.